Hi, this is Matthias from Windsor.ai, and today I'll show you how to sync Shopify data to BigQuery. Before you begin, please make sure you have admin rights to your Shopify store and that you have data. I have created orders here, which we will now import into BigQuery. Now, go to onboard.windsor.ai and then click on Shopify. Then you click on Shopify App Store, and you enter your URL here, grant access. Once you've installed the app, you'll be redirected back into the screen here. Then after you have repeated that process for all the stores you'd like to connect, in case you have many of them, you click on Preview and Destination. Now in here, you will start seeing Shopify data. I have different connectors connected here, so I make sure that I connect Shopify. Then what you can do here is you can select a fields preset. So I want to stream orders over. Then I click on Get Data. And then here I have the preview of the data. Here's my sample data set, which I have created. And now as a next step, we want to send that data over into BigQuery. What I do here is I click on BigQuery. And you will not have any destination task here. I have a few which are from other demos. So I'm just going to add destination task here. Now I will see here that these are all the fields I want to stream over. And now what I need is that dataset ID. So I'll get the project ID in, which is Windsor.ai over here. Then I have the dataset ID itself, which is Pied Piper, just this one here. And then I select a table name. I will call the dummy Shopify orders upload. Now for the insert, we need to have a columns to match. So I want to have fresh data every day without having duplicates. So I'm just going to sync by the order created at column. That is the column to match in this case. Now I'm creating a task name, so I'm just going to copy the same as a table name. And then here in the cloud storage bucket, you will need to have a cloud storage bucket as well. I have the bucket set up here. So I'm going to use marketing data Pied Piper and demo time as the storage folder. Now here the schedule is the time of day in UTC when the data will be synced. So I'm going to put in 3 a.m. UTC and then I click save. Now my data is being synced for the first time. Depending on your data volume, this can take up to a few minutes. Now the upload is completed. I turn green here. Upload, okay. So now if I go back into BigQuery, I should have the table appearing here. I might need to refresh for that to appear. I have the dummy Shopify orders data here, and the table was created with all the different fields which we have selected here. Now that the upload is successful, what we could also do is if I head back on edit, I could now run a backfill. Say if I would want to have 2 years worth of data synced over, I would simply select 2 years and then save, and then 2 years worth of data will be loaded. Now you would repeat that process for the other objects. We support customer, inventory items, marketing events, orders, and products. You just repeat that process and create a table for each of these Shopify objects, and then your data will be over. And you're ready to work with this data in BigQuery, and you can start working with it from there. Thanks very much for watching, and enjoy using our connectors.